This photograph from the U.S. Library of Congress shows a coal miner from 1942 from the Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania area, the Montour No. 4 mine of the Pittsburgh Coal Company. We don't even know the miner's name. We do know that a lot of miners have done very difficult jobs to help their families, to help their communities, to help their countries. And no one likes going around firing coal miners. Coal right now is under a lot of pressure. Some of it does come from government regulations. Probably more of it is coming from natural gas being cheaper, although you'll find argument on that. The economically optimal path for dealing with CO2 involves starting very slowly to deal with the problem and making changes over decades, with the idea in part that coal miners who made honest decisions to be coal miners will retire in their jobs, coal investors will get their money back, but future generations will do something else. If we ignore the science and the economics for now, we let another generation of coal miners get started, then the economically optimal path will involve much faster changes with a greater likelihood of firing coal miners. So in some sense, if you really hate the idea of firing coal miners, you want to put our knowledge into the decision-making now.